Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal Maynard recording for Channel Fireball. This week, following my primer on four color rites, or east-west rites as it should be named, at least. we've got the main deck that pretty much everyone who picked up the deck decided to not change. Tommy Ashton, the original designer of the deck in our team, designed, we changed like maybe three or four cards. We changed like a few cards in mana base, which was basically, to give you an idea, 3 weeks before the Pro Tour. We only had like three Evolving Wilds. We added a Fort one, we cut like a Kiz of Koilos, we added another Abbey, S24 land. We cut down on Zillipore Cutthroat because we basically realized it was only good with the combo. And we added like a third Brewmonitor and the 24th land. So it didn't change much. There isn't much to be changed, to be honest. In the main deck, it's very stuck. It's good at doing one thing. And the sideboard is actually something that you can change and play around a lot with, because it's really hard to build when you have company, because you can't board in too many cards. So I think the transformational sideboard against the sweeper deck is really good, which is four smashers, four discard spells, potentially negates depending on how many creatures they have in their deck, and the slot of Matter Reshaper, which I have actually changed since my article and last weekend. Actually trying it, I'm not sure. I had Sylvan Advocates, which I really liked, and our team was on Matter Shaper, theoretically. We didn't really have time to test it that much, so a few people ran like two and two advocates or whatever, or no advocates and a few Reshaper. Since I liked my four advocates, I just didn't change anything because I didn't have the time to test the Reshapers. But now that I have the time and I have a few weeks until my next Grand Prix, my next standard Grand Prix, I'm gonna try these Matter Reshapers over the advocates. I think the downside is that it's not as good against White Weenie as advocates. However, it's probably about as good or even better against the control decks, so we'll see how it is. And the rest hasn't changed. So for those who haven't played the deck or don't really know what's up, so this is kind of a mash between Banned Coco and the regular Black Green Rites. So what you're trying to do is try to draw Crypto the Throat. So this is sort of a based, it's not as based around as the Black Green Rites version, because we don't have Blister Pods, we don't have as many like small creatures to take advantage of the mana. However, it's still pretty good at just casting quickly cards like Brewmonitor, doing multiple things the same turn, or the main combo of the deck sort of is Displacer plus Reflector Mage, so it allows you to bounce any creature in instant speed at any time with 3 mana. So if you have a Cryptolithe and a bunch of colorless lands, you're able to activate Displacer multiple times, and or even activate Recruiter and find the combo. So the combo is Brewmonitor. The actual infinite combo is Brewmonitor plus Zillipore Cutthroat plus Displacer. So what you do is you pay 3 mana by sacrificing the 3 Scions, and you target Brewmonitor to blink it. So it comes back, you make 3 more Scions, you sag them, and you did. So you have a loop of infinite come into play triggers and die triggers. So if you have a Cutthroat in play, it deals infinite damage. And if you have a Sifter in play, it lets you scry your whole deck. So that's the reason we only played 2 Cutthroats, is that if you have a Sifter in play, then you can scry and find the Cutthroat. If you have enough mana, you can also blink, let's say your Visionary, or activate your Recruiter, play Cutthroat, and then kill them instantly in the same turn. Often you won't have enough mana, so you'll have to wait a turn. But it's usually fine because Brewmonitor provides 3 free blockers, so usually you have the time to draw. Yeah, you usually have the time to get another draw step. The mana base is kind of a work of art, to be honest. We never thought it would work until we actually played games. The reason it works is mostly because there are no aggressive red decks in the format. So you can't be punished for having a low life total. Of course, aggressive decks can punish you for having low life total, but because our deck stabilized the board so well, it means that they usually just, once by turn 5 or 6, you've stabilized the board and they just can't get through. Stuff like Grisboon or Flyers is a way to get there, but we have Displacer for that. So that's kind of why the mana base works. So this is sort of like a 4.5 color deck because you need your 4 colors, but you also need colorless for Displacer. So these Pain lands are really good for that reason, and it's why there's 11. Westvale Abbey is sometimes a way to win the game. Sometimes you have a Cutthroat in play, so it deals 5 plus the 9 haste. There's some decks that just can't deal with the 9-7 indestructible, like Ramp or Grixis. So it's a line of play that you often take. And of course, we have Evolving Wilds plus a bunch of basic lands. Usually, when you can get a forest early in the game, you won't be taking a bunch of pain lands, because it means you'll be able to get a Loam Dryad or Cryptolith Rite in play, and you'll stop taking pain damage. So it's better than it looks, to be honest. And the sideboard is, as I said, we use this transformational sideboard. The negates are for tragic carry against mostly. So green, white, and banned token, banned company. And ascetic is for the mirror and against white wing, excuse me. I'll be playing a league with the deck, so I'll see you there.